What's up?
Welcome back to the mill. Just been working away out here on this 400 board foot order for barn floor, all pitch pine, and I didn't know if I was going to be done or not, but I'm not going to be done. I'm getting close on this order. I'm only about 80 board feet away, and I'm going to do some cutting. I figured I'd let the video run because one thing that you guys never get to see me do is debark a log. So if you look at this pitch pine log, you know, even though I had it up on bunks, even though I'm trying to keep them clean, this one must have been on the ground. It's got a lot of dirt in it. I don't know how well it shows up on camera, but this is, you know, this is all dirt. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to debark it quick. Well, quick, relatively quickly. And I'll show you what I use. Hopefully this ends up being a good video. So I got this a long time ago when I was chainsaw milling. And it's like an edging tool. It's like an edging tool. Single bevel. I don't keep it that sharp because it'll dig in. And let's just show you how it works. Let me get you guys back a little bit here. So usually what I do is I leave the bevel against the log so it doesn't dig in. And I realize that, you know, it doesn't work this way on every log, but it's better than nothing. Some of this bark's pretty loose too, so I'll try to keep you guys in frame. Keep the bevel down, you can dig underneath without digging into the log. That's the majority of the dirt right there on that one pass. And also, you just ride the bevel along the log, kind of scrape the dirt off. This end's pretty good too. I don't know if I'm right in the way or not. Hopefully you can still see what I'm doing. So keep the bevel against the log. If I put the bevel down, it digs in like that. Keep the bevel, ride the bevel on the log like you would kind of paring into a corner with a chisel. Oops. You can get majority everything off pretty quick. But like I said, I realize it doesn't work like this on every log. You know, if this is a brand new, oak log, there's nothing that you're going to do to debark it. But doing this works pretty good. And you kind of like find the dirt, you can kind of just scrape it off too. Majority of dirt's off this log now. So I don't know exactly how much yield I'm going to get out of this one, but I'm going to cut it anyway. It was on the front of the pile. I'm not going to get all 80 out of this, but and then for like encrusted dirt, show you what I use. Just get this thing out of the way so I'm not tripping over it. I just keep it down under the mill, you know, just sitting down under the mill. But for like encrusted dirt, most of you guys have seen me, I got this brush that had a long handle on it, but I broke it the other day. And I just do my best just to brush it off if I see it. So it looks like the top of this log is pretty clean now. Should be able to make a few cuts without having a problem. Now, just to see the log, to see what we're dealing with. It's got a pretty good sweep like that. It's good out to about right where my finger is, and then it sweeps off really bad, which is no problem. If I had a saw right on hand with me, I'd cut it off and just do the straight part, but we'll deal with it. I'll cut that off on the one of the side passes. The way it's sitting is, it's got some funny S-shaped sweep like this too, and I kind of like the way it's sitting. I don't want to bring this end up. You can see that low spot. I don't want to bring that up because it's just going to make that bottom sweep worse. So I think it's just best to deal with it right where it is. There is still some dirt right there, and when I flip it over, I'll see it. It'll be on the outside, and I'll be able to just brush it off. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to get this thing dogged down and go to cutting here. See how much we can get done before it gets dark. So I might not say a lot, but I'm just going to mill along, and you guys can kind of just watch as I mill along here. Sometimes I just go into too much detail about what I'm doing. Makes everything long. It goes really fast when I don't talk. Kind of get through things pretty quick. Sort of note where I am. I'm at like basically 9 inches on both of these, so I know I can't go below that. We'll see how bad this is here. So it gets to cutting. That thing moving around when you're in the middle of a cut. So, just give myself an idea, take a quick measurement, here I go. Right here, to the top of the log is like 12. So, I think I'll skim it and then try it at 11. It's probably going to go down to 10, be my guess. should have cut this end off before I dealt with it. Here's the benefit of the Norwood right here. Having the Norwood to be able to move these. Thank you. come down to 9. If I want red tip, yeah, I want to leave some room. I don't want to necessarily think I'm going to get my 8-inch dimension this way. But it's going to be close. It's going to come down to 9, cut it, and flip it. Came down to 9 1/8, so I could take the 1-inch board off at 8 if I have to get me to 8 inches wide. Most of what I've cut is 1x8. And what I'm going to do is I'm gonna move that back over so it's kind of straight. We're going to flip it on its side and see what it looks like and see if I have to flip it twice. Whether this is going to hold this up good. Not really sure, so I'm gonna get back over to. I think someday I'll put measurements on here too, so I know where. I just kind of do it by eye to know about where I am. I think the sweet spot on these is about 4 inches over. Not from here, from the bracket. About 4 inches over, I think, is where they live most of the time. So there's a big sweep in this log right now, so I don't know which side I'd rather take off first, to be honest with you. No, it's gonna, usually gonna have to be up a little higher. Pitch pines are so much heavier than white pine. So I got so much more good wood here. I think I want this on the bottom. So I think I'm going to go over twice. Is that going to help me? That means that I'm going to true the top even if I have to shim it up. So I take the flattest cut. That gives me the most good wood down here because it sweeps like this, I think. Hopefully I didn't make a do something dumb here. No, I don't think I did. I don't have to shim it up. This is already up. So I think this is the best way to do it. Skim the top till it cleans up and then flip it. I think I did a good thing. I think I did a good job. I think should be, yeah. That's actually pretty good right there. Stay there. square. That's good. Alright, so we'll take the top off this. We'll see what our low point is here. There's going to be a little bit of waste here. There's obviously going to be some tension in this log, I think. So I'm going to start at 11, and it's probably going to come to 10. I don't want to pick based on just this angle here. There's 8.6. So I think I want to come, this sort of cleans up just past this line. If I end up with anything better, that's great, but I took 8 7/8. Right here, I'd get 8 1/8 this way. I'm thinking at 9 right now. Look at that. Am I like 9 inches wide? mill it straight down. Let's see if I can pick it, snatch it out of there. Of course, everything was going so good, we had to dump the fucking log in the ground, right? Oh, some real bad shake in it too, I can see. I think I got one more information.
Thank you.
trouble seeing into the sun. I wrecked one of my 1-inch boards. Wrap this. I'll wrap that log stop and then kind of panic and flip it. Okay. All right. Come on. Yeah, it's going to see me. Sorry about that. I wrecked that friggin' nice 1-inch board right there. Actually, I'm guessing there's some wind shaking this because of the way it is, the way it's sitting. So let's get back here just a little bit. Well, we'll go to milling now.
Hopefully, we don't wreck anything else.
So I want to know what my height is. I kind of want to skim into this. I'm gonna have some rain, so I'm gonna start about around 10 on scale. I'm gonna get on scale, mill it on scale. It's not gonna matter. I'm just gonna mill it right on 4/4 scale.
off here.
Where I can get at them here. Just where I can get at them. You can see what happened with that, not chopping that whole thing off and going down to that 8'6". So they end up pretty good. See a nice beam left over. We'll cut it out here and then I'll be done for the day. I can put everything away. Thank you.
one thing, I gotta get all this bark out from under my mill because it's starting to catch on shit.
Let's get these put up there. Those beautiful hard pitch pine one bys. You hear the nice cool noise they make when you pull them up there. Show them to you in 1 second here. These last couple up there. I'll add up the, do some measurements and add up the board feet and cut the ends off a couple of those and figure that some of them are going to be edged. Yeah, it's beautiful. This one's a little thick. I've been having that problem. This one's a little thick. Oh, the other one's a little thin, one of the two. Huh. I'm gonna check this part off. Looks thick to me. Hey, I don't have a tape on me. Should have worked out right on scale. That's 1¼. That's too thick. What about the one before it? That's 1 inch. That's weird. I've been having that happen every now and then. You know what I'm going to do really quick? I'm going to throw this one board back in the mill. And see if I can skim cut this down to 1 inch. I don't know why it came out 1¼. The blade rode up a little bit. I can see it looks like it started 1 inch. Might have finished 1 inch. I'm gonna double check it. Looks like the blade did a little bit of this going through that one. That's 1/16 down here. I bet it's 1 inch down the other end too. Yeah, it's 1 inch down here. This is the flatter side. I'm gonna throw this back on and see if I can skim cut it 1 inch. Go really slow. See if we can do it. Safely. So hopefully it doesn't lift. Okay, let's see if I can just do a 1-inch skim cut on it. Just chew it up a little bit so we don't have to deal with it. Hopefully that's some of you, that sucks. Oh yeah, a little bit. So I ran out of water on that last cut. So I think I'll be okay for a skim cut.
That's probably why that one cuts away. Skimming the top off like 16th deep. That'll get this well within spec. Show you what that looks like when I bring it over here. Hate how the video was short and then it got long. Oh, that did a great job. Board. Did a really nice job. That really trued it up perfect. That did a perfect job. All right. So the only thing that I'm going to do is when I scale these out, I won't take those ends into consideration. And that one's really no good. It'll end up either getting cut to a 1x4 or just trashed. Or I'll keep it for something else, but I'll just give them all the good ones. So, yeah, that's it. Ends up being 53 minutes. Amazing. I can see some wind shake in that board right above that knot right there. That board might not survive. I was hearing some funny rattling when I was cutting it. The band still did a pretty good job. Cutting smooth. I was getting some waves. I got a wave right there where my finger is. I can see it from here. But that's the one that I ran out of water on. So probably it was milling relatively flat through here. And then when it got to these and I ran out of water, it goes to hell in a handbasket. So, but for, you know, barn flooring, they'll be fine. So those will get added. I just have to keep a running total here, and that's it for today. Appreciate the watch. Appreciate you hanging out. Hope you guys have a great day.